It's about that time of the week. Greetings, summoners. My name is Nico, and today we have for you our updated 2.4 Hi-Elo tier list. This list is for the Hi-Elo, in a sense, ranks Emerald and higher, and assumes that those who are playing already have a firm understanding of the champion mechanics and everything surrounding the game. Now, without much further ado, let's jump right into it. First up on today's list, we have Trinamere in the A tier Baron lane. Yeah, you heard that right. He's finally escaped the garbage tier, and though he's not quite OP, he's finally viable. And all it took was a whole bunch of new crit items. He still doesn't have much crowd control, and except for when he has access to his Undying Rage, his frontline capabilities aren't so great either. These have been and still remain issues on the champion. But as an auto-attack reliant champion who has historically loved building crit, the addition of Navari Quickblade and other similar items allow for him to deal surprisingly large amounts of damage. The second champion is Gragas in our OP tier. Nothing much at all has changed about his kit or even his build over the course of the game's release. He's just super strong and has remained a very staple pick for a long period of time. There's really nothing new here in regards to how to build or play him. You still go practically full AP with some health and survivability if needed. The burst damage on his abilities once he acquires an item or two is pretty ridiculous, fully capable of decimating squishy targets in a flash. And since there happens to be a lot of squishy targets on Wild Rift lately, largely in part to practically everyone wanting to play ADCs, the Gragas pick is overpowered. The last Baron lane champion for today is Graves. Thanks to the critical item changes introduced in patch 2.4, the mercenary has become quite the wanted man. Graves is most conventionally played as a jungler, so why has he snuck his way into the Baron lane? Now that Bloodthirster grants crit, by rushing the item, Graves sustains very easily in lane while dealing phenomenal damage. Since his auto-attacks deal splash damage, thereby potentially hitting multiple targets at once, he can easily manage minion waves, pushing and trimming the wave as needed. And since Baron lane is just about 90% reliant on minion wave management, the marksman makes for a fantastic Baron lane champion. Here is the full Baron lane tier list. But real quick, before we move on, we have our question of the day. What champion or champion skin would you choose to cosplay as, assuming all costs and productions were taken care of? I would personally love to cosplay Draven, but I need to work out quite a lot for that to happen. Try to be creative with your answers down in the comments below. Alright, let's continue. We have the jungle up next. With no surprise, Graves up first in the S tier for his respective role. For jungle, however, we don't recommend building Bloodthirster first or potentially even any crit item first. Instead, rush Yumu's Ghostblade. The extra movement speed on the item is invaluable, providing the necessary mobility to effectively traverse the map. After Ghostblade is built, feel free to build more crit. We won't go into too much detail in this video, but if you want to learn about how to play Graves, be sure to check out our Graves video and guide that does exactly that. He's actually viable in mid as well, but we won't be spending any more time talking about him. Now with Graves out of the way, we have Fizz up next in our OP picks for the jungle. He's really been a sleeper OP pick for a while, but since not that many people were playing him a couple of weeks ago, it was really hard to tell exactly how strong the champion was. After all, his mechanics and viability rely very heavily on keeping tracks of his cooldowns and escape options, something that definitely takes a while to learn. When properly wielded, Fizz is fully capable of escaping any sticky situation, and thanks to his ultimate Chum the Waters, he has more than enough damage to completely burst down any marksman champion. This makes him the perfect pick for the jungle in patch 2.4, seeing as how people are going ADCs quite literally everywhere. The last jungle pick for today is Kha'Zix in our OP plus tier for this list. He's another prime example of a champion that hasn't necessarily been directly changed or updated, but has definitely been strong for quite some time. He still builds practically the same items as he did before, so pretty much full damage. Nothing about the jungle camps or his actual abilities have been touched. It's more so the meta and the popular champions that have allowed Kha'Zix to truly shine. And since he is an absolute monster who loves devouring his prey, squishy marksmen are the perfect meal for the apex predator. If you are playing a marksman and the enemy has a Kha'Zix, make sure you're never standing completely isolated. Here's the full jungle tier list. The first champion up for the mid lane is Yasuo in the S tier. The samurai has a lot more viable build paths now, allowing him to vary his itemization options according to the matchups more efficiently. In addition, he's the perfect champion to abuse Solari Chargeblade. This item grants a maximum of 50% crit, and since Yasuo's passive doubles critical chance, he can reach his 100% crit power spike much earlier on in the game than he did prior to patch 2.4. And since Wild Rift is fast-paced by nature, champions need to be able to influence the game to their fullest extent as fast as possible. For those of you looking to try out Yasuo, now's the best time as any. But don't get us wrong, you'll still get absolutely flamed and trash-talked for interlocking the pick. The second mid lane champion is Corki in our OP plus tier. The champion is honestly super oppressive to play against. He doesn't run out of mana, deals insane amounts of damage, and can even split the entire team apart by dividing through them with his package upgrade. He was already plenty strong before the ADC item changes, but now that he has even more items to abuse, the pick is running incredibly rampant in Wild Rift. Either his numbers need to be reduced a bit, or some of the new ADC items need to be nerfed before any semblance to balance can be seen on the Yordle. The last mid lane champion up is Twisted Fate in our OP tier for this list. I still remember when he was garbage tier for the longest time, so it's honestly so nice to see him finally standing well on his own. With very strong wave clear potential, high damage numbers and a card for every circumstance that he may find himself in, the ranged AP carry excels at accelerating a game, pushing leads all around the map. His ultimate grants vision and allows him to teleport across the map, both incredibly busted advantages to utilize in Wild Rift. Simply push mid, walk a bit out of lane and pop your ultimate. Skilled players should be able to easily access where to teleport, seeing as how literally all the enemy champions are visible, making Fog of War a non-issue. Here's the full mid lane tier list. With mid lane out of the way, we have ADCs up next, with Zarya up first. She's in the OP plus tier for this list. She's also like Corki, where she was already really strong before patch 2.4. The new item changes have really pushed her over the edge, allowing her to become an absolutely busted monster in Wild Rift. Now that she has some actual cooldown reduction options in her itemization path, her wave clear and damage has never been so strong. She can push faster than practically every other ADC in the game thanks to her constant access to feathers, which thereby allow her to easily take control of the laning phase. And since her ultimate literally grants her invulnerability, she has insane safety built into her kit as well. If you're looking for some free low, definitely abuse Zarya before people actually start banning her. Hopefully this video won't make people ban her more. I'm kind of abusing her to climb 2 at the moment. Jhin is up next in our A tier picks. You'd think the addition of Stormraiser and other crit items would help him, but in actuality, there are just a lot of better champions than Jhin at the moment. He doesn't have an escape and his overall DPS is severely lacking, especially in comparison with the top tier meta marksman champions at the moment. How can he compete with Lucian, who dashes around non-stop and throws out a billion auto-attacks in between skills? Or if you want to play a marksman who deals a lot of damage every auto, rather than hitting very fast, just play Draven instead. Jhin isn't necessarily weak, so for those looking for a reason to play him, go right on ahead. We will tell you though that there are definitely champions that simply perform his role better. Vayne is the last ADC for today in our A tier picks. She's finally viable and absolutely loves the inclusion of Solari Chargeblade. Since the item grants an incredibly large amount of critical chance, Vayne now has the proper damage output to duel properly. Of course, she's still weighed down by her lack of wave clear, which is a huge weakness to have in an ADC. But her damage as a whole is super impressive, and those who understand the champion's limits should finally be able to live out the hyper late game fantasy that comes along with playing Vayne. Here's the full ADC tier list. Last but not least, we have the support role with Lulu up first in our A tier picks. She's been seeing a lot more play since she's one of the best, if not the best support pick to buff an allied marksman. Simply throw out all her base abilities onto a strong ADC and they should be able to clear out the game thereafter. Of course, since she doesn't deal much damage on her own, the pick is very reliant on the skills of allied marksmen, making the pick a tad bit risky. The easiest proven way to climb ranked is rely on your own skills, and since Lulu relies on the skills of others, she's only at our A tier picks. If you are actually doing with a competent ADC, Lulu is oppressively powerful. Lux is second up in our A tier picks. Before we said she was overpowered, but after some more playtests, it seems the pick is too reliant on team coordination to effectively pull off. And as previously mentioned before, having this trait in a champion is suboptimal, relying too heavily on luck. By the way, this isn't full AP Lux, but actual support Lux building Harmonic Echo and stuff of flowing water. The last pick for the day is Alistar in our A tier picks. He is still a really solid tank support option with reliable engage and crowd control to create plays. But ever since the addition of Senna, who can easily kite him down from a distance and get him too low to engage, the Cowman has been a little sad. Here is the full support tier list. That concludes today's video. We hope you enjoyed the content, and if you did, leave a like and subscribe to the channel for everything Wild Rift related. Until next time, stay safe and good luck on your ranked climbs.